The lecture today about immediate denture. First of all, there are different treatment options for a patient facing loss his or her remaining natural teeth. Immediate denture is one of these options that fulfill an important role in today's treatment modalities by providing the patients with aesthetic function and psychological support after extraction and during the healing phase. The definition for immediate denture is any complete or partial removable dental prosthesis fabricated for placement immediately following the removal of natural teeth. The indication for immediate denture: patient with hopeless remaining teeth, educated patient with daily social activities, patient with a stable health condition, and patient don't mind some additional visits or costs. Contraindication: poor general health, systemic disease, and cooperative, indifferent, and unappreciative patient, risk from bacteremia, history of post-extraction hemorrhage, acute periapical or periodontal diseases, and extensive bone loss. Patients don't mind being edentulous for a period of time. The advantages: appearance first, second, circumoral support, muscle tone, vertical dimension, and face height can be maintained, less post-operative pain, and the fourth point, easier to duplicate the natural tooth shape and position. The patient is likely to adopt more easily, and patient's psychological and social well-being is preserved. Disadvantage for immediate denture: the anterior ridge undercut. If there is an undercut in the anterior area, this is a disadvantage and painful area. The presence of different number of remaining teeth in various locations leads to recording incorrectly the centric relation or vertical dimension of occlusion, because maybe those teeth are super erupted or maybe malposed. The inability to accomplish a try-in. There is no try-in stage in immediate denture because you are intended to remove the teeth at the time of insertion. More chair time, additional appointments on cost, functional activities are likely to be impaired. The types of immediate denture. First, we have the conventional or the classic one, immediate denture, and the second, which is the interim or transitional or non-transitional immediate denture. Simple comparison between the conventional immediate denture definitive and the interim immediate denture transitional, which is called. So this is definitive treatment, and the other is a transitional treatment intended as the final or long-term prosthesis for the conventional immediate, and the interim immediate intended for short-term use only. The first one, after healing, it is relined with acrylic resin, while the second one, after healing, a second denture is made. For the conventional interim, conventional immediate denture, indicated when two extraction visits are feasible, while for the other type, indicated when only one surgical visit is preferable to maximize insurance benefits. For the first treatment, the aesthetic of the denture cannot be changed, while for the second denture procedure, for the second one or second type of immediate denture, the second denture procedure allows an alteration of aesthetic and all other factors if indicated. Another point Another comparison between the conventional immediate denture and interim immediate denture. For the conventional one, at the end of the treatment, the patient has one denture. For that of the interim, at the end of the treatment, the patient has a spare denture to use. The vertical dimension of occlusion is not preserved for the conventional immediate denture. However, you can keep the bicusp and you can maintain the occlusion. Vertical dimension, the occlusal vertical dimension, for that of the conventional immediate denture. For the interim immediate denture, since posterior teeth need not be removed, vertical dimension of occlusion may be preserved. On the conventional immediate denture, contraindication for patient who will need complicated treatment plan involving both arches. In case of interim, other indicated, often indicated in patients with complicated treatment plan. Denture can be classified according to type of restoration into first, immediate complete denture, second, immediate partial denture, third, immediate over denture. According to flange, also we can classify the immediate denture. We have flanged type, complete flange and partial flange, and we have open-faced flangeless type, open face or close fit as this case. Comparison of flanged and open-faced denture. First, the appearance. Second, the freedom in the positioning of teeth. In upper denture, a flanged one gives better retention than is achieved with an open-faced denture. In lower denture, open-faced denture give poor stability of lower denture during function. So, flanged denture is commonly used in lower denture. Labial flange produces a stronger denture, will give a strength to the denture. Another point to be considered in the comparison for flanged and open face denture, the presence of labial flange made it easier to add relining material as a chair-side procedure. The flange denture cover the clot completely and reduce post-extraction hemorrhage. The consequence wearing of ill-fitting denture for that of the open-face denture. The next point, when patient have got used to an open face immediate denture will complain from the fullness of the lip if the receive flange denture in the future. If he received flange denture in the future, he will complain from a fullness of the lip because he is not adapted for the situation. When the ridge morphology produces deeply undercut using of partially flange denture or open face denture is preferable when surgical procedure is contraindicated. You need to explain the patient concerning the immediate denture the following points. They do not fit as well as complete denture because it is replaced immediately. They will cause discomfort. The aesthetic may be unpredictable. Many other denture factors are unpredictable, like the position of the teeth, the leveling of the occlusal plane, the speech maybe. So immediate denture must be worn for the first 24 hours without being removed by the patient. This is another point to be considered. Immediate denture may loosen up during the first 1 to 2 years or 4 to 6 months, depending on the number of teeth and their location. We start with some diagnostic steps. First, before we are in our treatment planning, before we start the treatment concerning the immediate denture. First, good oral hygiene and patient systemic condition. We need to consider these two points before starting with the treatment. Another one, which is periodontal condition of the remaining teeth, may suggest some surgical correction after extraction. Correction for what? For the bone surrounding the teeth. Full teeth charting. That means you need to record every tooth situation. Teeth may help in retention as a periodontal, as a partial denture or overdenture abutment. Must be determined. Radiographic examination. You need to examine the teeth radiographically. This will give us an idea about the level of the bone surrounding the teeth and situation of the bone also. Teeth mold and shade must be recorded for the present teeth. It is very important to remove any premature contacts before taking impression. Occlusal plane adjustment. Presence of any infection or inflammation in the soft and hard tissue, periapical abscess may make the estimated tissue changes at the time of extraction and healing and remodeling process unpredictable. This may increase the risk of unfitted immediate denture. Previous prosthesis. If the patient has a previous prosthesis, we need to consider that. Diagnostic costs are essential. You need to take the impression, the primary impression, to make a diagnostic cast in order to study the case from all situations and from all aspects. Surgical procedure treatment plan can be performed by first extraction of the teeth only, second extraction of teeth with alveoloplasty. We have two options. Either we extract the teeth only, no need for alveoloplasty, or we need to do extraction and alveoloplasty. The primary impression we need to select the proper stack tray. In some cases, when the remaining teeth are very loose, there is a risk of teeth extraction during impression making. So try to preserve these teeth either by applying a lubricant medium to the teeth, or in case of adjacent teeth are present, use soft wax into subcontact points, spaces, and around the neck of teeth. In case of some cases, the primary impression may be useful as a final impression in case of immediate single tooth replacement with or without short span partially edentulous arch. Primary cast to plane the sequences of the treatment as well as used to construct the special tray, surveying, undercut block, out and relief must be done on the cast. We are now going to talk about the final impression. Different tray design and impression technique were described to deliver final impression. These techniques may range from simple to more complicated, depending on tray design and materials used. Selection of a suitable technique depending on first case difficulty, number and location of teeth included in the immediate denture treatment. That means you are going to extract these teeth. Teeth and tissue undercut, dentist skill and experience. We have two types of impression procedure, single full arch, custom tray, or sectional impression tray. For single full arch custom tray, use for conventional immediate denture, the only tray used for interim immediate denture. Only one tray you will use, anterior teeth only or anterior and posterior remaining teeth. We have both or either anterior and posterior teeth remaining. On the primary cast, outline the tray extension to be shorter than the vestibular depth by 2 mm and include the posterior limit. For the first technique, the remaining teeth must be covered with single layer of sheet wax. The first technique, single layer of sheet wax. Then second layer is used to cover all the area needed to be recorded by the impression. For the second technique, all the teeth and denture foundation area are blocked using 2 layers of wax. A stopper made by making 4 to 5 regular holes through the wax symmetrically distributed anteriorly and posteriorly. Finally, adapt the cold cured acrylic resin duff layer to fabricate the special tray. Finish and smooth the borders and surfaces. Proper perforations must be done symmetrically as possible, or using adhesive depending on the type of impression material you are going to use. Now we need to check the tray in the patient's mouth and do border molding by using a tracing compound, as usual with the final impression for the conventional complete denture. And you may also need to use irreversible hydrocolloid, polyvinyl siloxane or silicone impression material, polysulfide and polyether. More expert dentists may use two impression material in one tray for maximum accuracy. That means you use heavy body and light body in the same tray. Sectional impression tray or split impression tray technique. This use two tray or sectional custom tray used in conventional immediate denture only and cannot be used in interim immediate denture. It involves construction of two trays on the same cast, one for the posterior region as in the complete denture, and the second is constructed for the anterior region below a backless tray. Indices of references must be made in the tray. Outline the tray extension on the cast, block undercut, and use spreading media. For the posterior region, adapt the cold cured resin mix to the posterior edentulous area and extend it to cover the lingual surface of the anterior teeth beyond the incisal edge, then put the handle. For the anterior region, you may use a second sectional tray that it indexed to the primary tray. The two sections are reassembled outside the mouth using the indices and prepared for casting. You may adapt and cut a plastic stock tray to fit the anterior section. The anterior section of the impression must record the labial aspect of the teeth as well as the vestibular area. The posterior sectional tray must be tried for proper extension. Border molding is made, then final impression for edentulous area is made by using zinc oxide eugenol impression, polyvinyl siloxane or polysulfide, or you can use polyether, and you can use non-elastomeric impression material here. Proper seating of the trays and reassembling both as shown in the figure. Modification of the above technique can be made as to make a full tray covering the denture being ring area with a hole opposite to the teeth area. Again, we do border molding and impression, then a proper stuck tray cover the custom one. Can be used to capture the teeth area with alginate material. There is a window, and this window will adapt over the remaining teeth. The other tray will superimpose over this window to capture the remaining teeth. beading and boxing. All the impression must be beaded before pouring. Pour the impression and remove the tray as in the conventional manner. Record base and occlusion rim. If enough number of remaining anterior and posterior teeth present, no need for record base or bite rim, as in most of intermediate denture. While if there isn't enough number of remaining teeth, as in all of the conventional immediate denture, and some of the intermediate denture cases, bite rim must be constructed. Undercuts must be blocked out by wax, then cold cure acrylic doff is applied on the edentulous area. Those figures show us how to construct the denture base and bite for the immediate denture. Now, jaw relation record. Include vertical and horizontal relation as in the conventional denture construction. Evaluation of the existed vertical dimension of occlusion must be accomplished, and dentist must decide if this going to be restored or modified. In the immediate complete denture, leave first premolars bilaterally to maintain vertical and horizontal relation and facilitate recording of the jaw relation. The procedure for face bone transfer, vertical dimension determination shown in those pictures. Jaw relation record also include face bone transfer and centric jaw relation must be recorded. Once you record vertical and horizontal relation, you are ready to mount the cast on a suitable articulator. Consider all parameters in teeth selection, in the anterior and posterior segment, shed, size, form, and occlusal, which include occlusal form of posterior teeth, which must be selected to fit each case specifically. Arrangement of posterior teeth done in the same way as in the conventional complete denture, maintain proper occlusal plane. Now we are reaching the trying stage. In this way, you set the posterior or anterior missing teeth to try it in the patient's mouth, check and verify occlusal plane and jaw relation in the trying step. Try in step is not possible in every immediate denture case, but even so, mounting of the master cast must be confirmed in patient's visit. The trial denture now must be tried in the patient's mouth. Verify the vertical and centric relation. If there is an error, can be detected in the centric relation. Lower cast must be remounted after a new record, and teeth must be reset. Confirm all the landmarks recorded in the diagnostic step to set the patient's desire as first the midline, the anterior plane of occlusion. Use some of the anatomical landmarks, enter pupillary line and parallelism with the elateragus line. High lip line, amount of display of the teeth and gingiva. At the end of the try-in visit, you have to check all what is related to the present teeth and mark all what you have to change teeth and tissue. Now, cast trimming. Trimming of the cast must be done carefully to simulate as possible the shape of the residual ridge after teeth extraction. The first step in trimming, you need to remove tooth at the gingival level, while the second step, you need to recess socket 1 millimeter, that means deepen the socket 1 millimeter. Labial edge recess to incisal third mark. You have to reduce the labial edge to the incisal edge third mark. The fourth step, midpoint recess to mid-width labial cut. The fifth step, as shown in the figure. And the fourth, you need to round all the edges. For posterior teeth, a cross-sectional view of cast in the posterior region, coronal segment is removed using saw or laboratory engine. 1 millimeter deep recess is created in area occupied by root. Vertical cut extending from facial extend of prepared socket to the line denoting junction of cervical and middle thirds of facial surface. Cut extending from faciolingual center of socket to midway point of cast, floor of a prepared socket extending lingually. Stone contours are gently rounded at facial and lingual surfaces. Cross-sectional view of teeth placement and denture base contours. We need to note amount of grinding, which is very minimal on the palatal side. Final ridge form must be round and continuous. Cast trimming may be done at same time of teeth arrangement. Do not change or trim the essential landmarks as incisive papilla or any frenum. Setting of anterior teeth. More than one method may be used to trim and set the teeth in immediate denture cases. It depends on if the teeth are need to be changed in location or alignment to improve the aesthetic. The teeth are well aligned aesthetically and functionally acceptable, then we can reproduce same alignment in the denture. The first way, produce a labial index from silicone. So molding silicone putty against the labial surface of the teeth, artificial teeth can be set into the index while it's held against the cast pressure, preserving some teeth location. In this technique, same teeth morphology and location is duplicated. The second way, which is the alternative or other method, you can use every tooth as an index to arrange same tooth but in the other side, or trim all the teeth on one side and use the other side as a reference. Those pictures show the way of arrangement of the teeth after shaping of some the cervical area of the arranged teeth. Surgical splint after complete cast trimming guide the surgical shaping of the alveolar process. Duplicate the cast, make the clear template processed either by heat or light form. Advantages of the splint: it will help to remove any expected pressure area at the site of extraction, thus minimize insertion time and adjustment of the insertion at the insertion time. Waxing and flasking as usual method followed in the conventional denture. Accessing also the same as the conventional denture construction. The insertion procedure. At the day of surgery and insertion, extraction of the marked teeth, preserve the labial plate and be conservative. Use the surgical template to guide any alveolar correction. Seat the template blanch areas seen through the template indicates pressure, then need correction. Insert the denture, remove all the detected overextended, correct any pressure areas, check the frenum relief, check for firm bilateral occlusion with no gross occlusal interference, quickly correct. At the day of insertion, try to reduce the number of insertion and removing of the denture to avoid trauma and edema. Post-operative care and instruction. The first 24 hours, avoid removing the immediate denture. Put gentle biting pressure on your denture during the first 4 hours. Avoid hard food and eat soft, healthy food. Avoid drinking hot fluids using ice pack. In the first 24 hours, patient should be reminded that the pain from extraction will not reduce by removal of the denture. There may be some oozing of blood. The denture acts as a bandage to protect the extraction sites and helps to control bleeding and swelling. First, adjustment must be done after 24 hours. The denture should be kept out of patient mouth only for short time, just sore area which appears as deep red areas, mostly undercut as canine eminence, tuberosity, and retromyelohyoid ridge. Don't use pressure indicating paste. Second, adjustment must be done after 1 week. Relieve sore spot using pressure indicating paste, adjust occlusion, assess retention, and use tissue conditioner if needed. First week after extraction and denture insertion, instruct your patient to wear the denture day and night for first 7 days after extraction or until swelling reduction. Remove the denture 4 or 5 times a day. After the first day, rinse the mouth with warm salt water. Do this for the first week. The denture must be cleaned and rinsed after meal as early as possible. Further follow-up care. Second week is the next call. This is depend on the case. Then the patient should be seen 1 month later for 4 to 5 to 6 month interval. A denture adhesive will be necessary to help hold the denture in place. Relining may be necessary to achieve aesthetic and occlusion correction, a frequent or periodic recall. The case report we need to discuss with each other: a male patient, aged 52 years, reported to the Department of Prosthodontics. He works as a teacher in an institute of sciences. He wants to have a replacement for his missing teeth. Routine case history was recorded. Post-dental history revealed a 2 year period of completely edentulous mandibular arch and partially edentulous maxillary arch. The patient had whitish complexion and normal giant. Intraoral examination revealed that teeth present were 11, 12, 13, 21, 22, 23, and 24. Both arches are medium size and square in form, as shown in figure 1 and 2. An orthodontomograph or gram of the patient revealed bone loss in maxillary anterior region up to maxillary primary impression was made with a reversible hydrocolloid alginate impression material, shown in figure 4, and mandibular impression was made with impression compound, as shown in figure 5. Special tray fabricated for maxillary cast, final impression for the mandibular and maxillary arch. Vertical and horizontal jaw relation were recorded, teeth arrangement and trial was done. Maxillary anterior teeth were then trimmed on the cast, and cast was smoothened up to the level of posterior ridge with sandpaper. maxillary anterior teeth were then arranged. The dentures were then processed with heat cure polymethyl methacrylate resin. All the teeth present were extracted and suturing was done. Denture insertion was done at the same appointment. Post-insertion instructions were given and patient recalled after 24 hours for follow-up. Thank you. For your listening.